pizza, bro. Finish there. Day and night. I toss and turn, I keep stressing my mind.
I look for peace, but see, I don't attend. Yeah, boys.
Don't be scared, Khan. Just text me a final session, bro.
Hey guys, hope you guys are doing well. Welcome to this segment or part of this video. Apologies also, I'm not feeling 100% at the moment, so my voice is probably a bit more nasally than what it usually is. My voice is already funny anyway, so it probably doesn't even matter, but we're gonna be looking at Mooji Mooji today, guys. I don't know about you guys, but I've always been interested in trying to design my own clothes, have my sort of own brand, and obviously with that you need a decent kind of blank to print on or to design on as your canvas. I found a brand called Mooji Mooji. Apparently these guys are based out of California over in the States. I checked the website and it seemed pretty decent in terms of the variety, the quality, the price was pretty good as well, the colorways that they had. I ended up ordering 4 different items, guys. I got 2 oversized crop t-shirts in sort of the sun fade black colorway. Those cost me $36 a piece, $36. I ended up also getting a classic work jacket in aged black in size large, and another classic work jacket in aged olive green colorway. Both those work jackets were about $88. For reference, I'm around 178 centimeters, 5'10", around 70 kgs. Cool story, bro. Honestly, guys, unfortunately, this review is not a positive one. Let me tell you why. So I picked this bad boy in a size large. Well, it's not even a bad boy because it's going to be a negative review. I picked this boy up in a size large, guys. A pretty decent drop shoulder, as you guys can hopefully see. Not as big as I thought it would be compared to how boxy some other kind of brands do their oversized clothing. Collar is relatively thick, not as thick as I wanted it to be. Detachable Mooji Mooji tag in there as well, and you can kind of see the back stitching. Reason number one why I would not recommend Mooji Mooji, guys. As I mentioned when I was going over my packing slip before, I ordered 2 t-shirts. I ordered 2 oversized t-shirts, the same one, 2 of them. And when I opened up my package, guys, unfortunately, there's only 1 of them that came. They stuffed up the order for me, and that is one reason why I am a little bit annoyed at Mooji Mooji. In terms of the work jackets, these are the work jackets that I got. You guys may have noticed that one of them is zipped up, the other one isn't zipped up. And this gets right to my second point around why I wouldn't buy from Mooji Mooji, or why I wouldn't recommend Mooji Mooji. The reason why this guy isn't zipped up is because as soon as I tried it on, guys, as soon as I tried to zip up the jacket, the actual zip just fell off and broke off the jacket. Obviously these work jackets are very sort of reminiscent or trying to play off this sort of vintage Carhartt, Dickies sort of chore, Detroit style jacket. I do own a pair of both of those brands, and this does not compare at all. This will not keep you very warm. There's no lining inside of these jackets. Unfortunately, you can't actually see that on the website. It's literally just a nice sort of cotton shirt, literally structured as a zip-up jacket. 2 front pockets on both sides. You got the sort of rip-away kind of Mooji Mooji tag over there. Nothing else. Overall, guys, pretty disappointing for the price that I paid, $250 for 3 garments. I would not recommend that, unfortunately. Maybe you guys have had better experiences, please let me know. But just from my experience, the fact that I had 1, a missing garment in my order, and 2, the zip already falling off, it was pretty disappointing. So hopefully it's helpful for you guys. Just quickly, guys, go over some recent pickups that I've made. First one is a t-shirt I'm wearing right now. This is the Cole Buxton Flight Camp Tee in black. I've always wanted to rock this one and cop this one. I do have the Cole Buxton warm-up shorts as well, and they're probably my favorite shorts right now. So functional, so comfortable, and so steezy. So I had to cop this Flight Camp Tee as well. Super good fit, relatively oversized. And my other pickup, guys, is just this really nice vintage Van Heusen kind of cable-ish knit sweater. I got this off eBay, as I usually do. Size extra large, just a classic sort of Van Heusen. Obviously very reminiscent of that sort of vintage Coogee or Biggie Smalls type of style, and yeah, I'll definitely be rocking this a lot during the winter time over here in Auckland. I also will answer more Q&A in the next one, guys. I just wasn't able to do it in this one. I didn't really have enough time. I'm so sorry if you were expecting some Q&A. Coming, mum.
Hello?
Hey,
Sorry.
How is it?
We're almost there.
Nice.
Morning guys again, good afternoon actually. I just dropped my mum off guys. I gave her a pamper kind of spa treatment. Driving to the office now guys, my favourite place to be honestly on a Saturday. Thought it'd be more efficient if I just go to work, wait it out while she gets her pamper treatment. At work, do a bit of work, work. Keep saying the same thing bro.
Yeah, this is pretty much the view guys of the office. We're on the 16th floor. It's a beautiful view of Auckland, Rangitoto Island, PwC. My desk is super messy right now, eh?
Next minute.
Gonna go pick up mum now guys, but before I do that, I'm just gonna do a bit of quick vintage shopping, see what's good at one of the stores that's pretty close to the office, parlor store. Let's go downstairs, eh?
Ah, damn, it's close. All good, I think. It is close. Oh well. Next time, next time.
Happy Friday guys, welcome back to another video. Welcome back to the greatest city in the world, one of the greatest cities in the world, Tokyo. Back with another sort of weekday vlog today guys. Gonna get lunch first, gonna choke you guys. I'm here in an area guys in Tokyo called Kyobashi. It's relatively close to sort of the Marunouchi, central Tokyo area. I don't know too much about it, but I know there's a real sick restaurant here that I've been to in my top five for sure, so I'm gonna go there now for lunch. Let's go! This place is called Heusen, I think it is. Gonna get this real mean maguro kind of bowl, tuna bowl. Super good, guys. A lot of sort of salaryman come here for lunch. It's honestly legit. I can't wait to show you guys what the bowl looks like.
This is it, guys. 200 grams of tuna, raw tuna marinated in sort of soy sauce. Got some pickled veggies, some miso. Got your raw egg and seaweed and nori and your rice. First thing I like to do is just mix up the egg, break it up, and that pretty much acts as your dipping sauce for the raw fish.
Tuna, dip it in the raw egg.
And what I like to do when I'm done with my rice guys, and I usually have rice left in there and a bit of fish left, I just chuck in that raw egg bro, put that in there.
Next minute.
What a meal bro, far out. Up to the brim, very satisfying way to spend 1,100 yen only as well, which is awesome. As I was saying before guys, I am in Kyobashi right now, part of Tokyo. I'm just gonna quickly walk to Ginza, go to this bookshop that I've been to before and just pick up some magazines or a magazine. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Got my magazines guys, gonna be some good daytime reading slash I can't read them by just looking at the pictures for pretty much outfit inspiration really. Gonna get a coffee now from Knots and then actually start working. Today. I guys got my coffee. Jesus, real super hot today, super humid. As you guys can probably see, I'm real sweaty, yeah. But
super refreshing. Really needed that to get some work done, eh? You guys, I just went outside. Sorry, it's really windy right now. It's always, sometimes it can be really windy in the street. Just had a call a couple of hours, an hour ago. Decided to go outside just to make the most of the weather before I go home. Looks like I'm going to be busy for the next month or so, pretty much. So, great. Fantastic, eh?